Hello! Welcome back to Biognosys YouTube channel. My name is Monika and I'm a member of Biognosys support team. In this video tutorial, I would like to show you how to analyze DIA data using Biognosys directDIA workflow with streamlined library enrichment, our recommended workflow for even deeper proteome coverage. In addition, I would like to walk you through new visualizations and options available in Spectronaut 16. Let's move to the software. In the analysis perspective, we will start with selecting directDIA analysis. Biognosys spectrum-centric DIA analysis workflow that uses a FASTA protein database as an input. directDIA doesn't require a prior generation of the spectral library, since the project-specific spectral library will be generated directly from DIA runs in the first step of the workflow. Briefly, based on the DIA acquired precursors and fragment ion features, as well as their retention time correlation, Spectronaut will generate the convoluted MS2 spectra that will be used for the classical database search in Pulsar with selected FASTA files. After applying library filters, a DIA data-derived spectral library is ready for the targeted quantitative analysis. To start a directDIA workflow, we will select raw DIA MS runs. In this tutorial, we will analyze 6 DIA passive samples from 4 species: human, E. coli, C. elegans, and S. cerevisiae, which were mixed in different proportions in 2 different experimental conditions. A 2-hour chromatographic gradient was applied prior to the acquisition of mass spectra. In the second step, all we need to select are the FASTA files of the 4 species. In this analysis, we'll use default settings as they are recommended for most DIA projects. You can view and change the settings if needed. For a better user experience, we introduced 2 different layouts in Spectronaut 16, including a basic set of settings and advanced ones. You could also select here a settings schema of your choice, predefined in the settings perspective. In this step, we can specify experimental conditions by editing the condition setup or by uploading a condition setup file, predefined for the given project. Here, you can select the geo-annotation files for the geo-enrichment analysis. Finally, we can select additional DIA or DDA runs for the Pulsar search. Those runs will be used to enrich the project-specific library and improve the depth of proteome coverage in the analyzed DIA project. Since searching is a computationally and time-consuming process, another convenient solution for a library enrichment, when available, is the selection of search archives, namely the combined PSM search results of the additional DIA and DDA runs. Whether you use runs or search archives for the library extension, Spectronaut will make sure that you get a library that is FDR controlled, which is 1% at PSM, peptide, and protein group levels by default. In this video tutorial, we will enrich directDIA using search archives of deeply fractionated 2-hour DDA passive runs acquired for the same 4 species samples. Now we are ready to start the analysis. By default, Spectronaut will also generate search archives from the Pulsar search performed for this analysis. Those search archives will be available to enrich spectral libraries of future experiments. Once the processing is finished, you can review different information derived for your data at a run, protein group, and precursor levels. One of the new visualizations on the run level is a DIA acquisition method overview, where you can see details on how the DIA acquisition method was constructed. That plot next to the ion mobility overview is a convenient tool for inspection of the correctness of the used method and serves the purposes of acquisition method development and optimization. Another new addition to the analysis review on the run level is a mass error histogram at MS2 and MS1 levels, which could be used for data quality control and mass spectrometer behavior monitoring. The tree view will allow you to go further into the details of the identification and quantification of each precursor. In order to navigate through thousands of precursors easily, you can use a number of practical filters related to peak features, quantification, identification, and assay. Among those, you can find the newly added filters for modifications and protein databases. The grid view, on the other hand, offers a user-friendly overview of the quantification results displayed in a protein group-centric manner. Grid view data can now be easily exported from the report perspective using a dedicated grid view report schema. On the right side, you can find protein coverage plot and condition box plot representing quantities of the protein precursors within experimental conditions. Like many other plots in Spectronaut, the condition box plot has additional functions accessible after right-clicking on the plot. For example, we can change the base of the display data from precursors to protein groups. Differential analysis results, as well as quantitative and qualitative analysis results on the experimental level, can be found in the post-analysis perspective. In the analysis summary section, we can find information on the number of identifications at protein, peptide, and precursor levels. In the presented analysis of DIA passive data acquired for mixed species proteome, the enrichment of our spectral library with DDA search archives led to significantly more identifications on the protein group level and on precursor level compared to a similar analysis without library enrichment. Among other intuitive visualizations of the data, you can find a ranked protein groups plot that shows all the identified protein groups ranked according to their quantitative value. By selecting one of the boxes above the graph, you can choose to show labels of all candidates of the differential analysis or only of the selected ones. Newly added quantitative variance indicators in red represent the distribution of protein abundances in different experimental runs. In this specific project, we expected high protein abundance differences on the global level, as 3 out of 4 different species samples were used with a different concentrations in both experimental conditions. For the benchmarks, including mixed species samples, Spectronaut features a dedicated LFQ bench plot. The plot will be generated automatically if more than one species is detected in selected FASTA files. The expected ratios, dashed lines, can be set by right-clicking on the plot. The distributions on the right side of the plot show how the experimental values diverge from the expected ratios. Finally, all the proteins that are differentially regulated between the two experimental conditions can be found in the candidates list and the related volcano plot. And with this, we reached the end of this video tutorial. We hope that working with Spectronaut 16 will be as exciting for you as it was exciting for us to create it. If you like this video, please give it a big thumbs up. If you would like to see future video tutorials, please subscribe to Biognosys YouTube channel. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.